FYI, time travel is possible. So they just mentioned these Kerr black holes as well, which is super interesting. You could possibly cross the middle of this ringed singularity, mini black holes at the LHC.
G'day, my smart mates. My name's Dylan Dance. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Grab a coffee. Actually, where is my coffee? Grab a coffee. Grab an Apollo 11 space capsule. Grab whatever you want. Let's talk some natural philosophy.
So this video will probably end up being really long, so I'll probably break it into two parts. So make sure you subscribe if you want to catch the next part.
宇宙には始まりはあるが終わりはない。無限。
Straight into it. The universe has a beginning, but no end. That's the current way of thinking. That's, you know, the consensus in the physics community. But it isn't the only way to look at what we currently see out there in the universe. It is the one that has the most evidence that there was a beginning and there is seemingly no end.
星にもまた始まりがあるが、自らの力を持って滅びゆく。有限。
And if you didn't know, you're actually made of star stuff. Now, most people have heard old Carl Sagan say this, but yeah, the stuff making you up, all the heavy elements in your body come from exploding stars. Star stuff. And the stuff in your left hand probably comes from a different star to the stuff in your right hand. Anyway, let's see if we can make it past 30 seconds.
Kangaroo.
Does that mean kangaroo in Japanese?
人数が少ないな。
Kangaroo,
やはり機関の妨害が入っているか。
Open through space time?
何が始まる？タイムマシン。すごいね。
中鉢博士は、We're going to time machines, are we? So if this show is about time machines, that means everything that happens at the start is probably very important. I mean, the episode is called Prologue of the Beginning and End. Hint, hint. So let's keep watching. I'd tell a time travel joke, but you didn't like it. If you watched my last video, I've already used that one, but
我々研究者の抜け駆けをし、この世紀の発明の発表会へとこぎつけた。たっぷりとその考えを聞かせてもらうつもり。地震か？いや。これは？
It's probably a time machine, given what the show's about. It's probably him.So before I try and explain what time is, and whether or not time travel is possible, I reckon we watch a bit more of the show and see what it has to say. Then I can give you guys what I know. So FYI, time travel is possible. You're doing it right now as you're traveling into the future. You're time traveling. And as you look out into the universe, you're looking out into the distant past because space and time are the same thing.Wrapped up into this one thing, space-time. So as you look through space, you're looking through time and blah, blah, blah. So let's keep watching and we can talk about more about time in a minute.
セルンとは何だ？タイターは言っていた。セルンが2034年までにタイムマシンを。
Yeah, look, it's a great storyline. Fantastic idea. But I don't think so. Trying to build time machines or mess with things like time in that way. So...Think you guys can all relax with that one. I mean, if you had a look at the Large Hadron Collider, LHC, you'd probably think it's some sort of, like, something like a time machine as well. It looks magnificent.
なんだではない。あなたのタイムマシン理論はなんだ。カーブラックホール、世界線、すべてジョン・タイターの。
So they just mentioned these Kerr black holes as well, which is super interesting because they're these hypothetical black holes in which you possibly could survive.Crossing the event horizon. So normally with black holes, if you were to fall into one, you'd be torn, you'd be spaghettified into a stream of quarks. You'd be crushed by the tidal forces, the increase in gravity as you approach the singularity inside, which supposedly has infinite gravity, right? So with a Kerr black hole, it's just a spinning black hole. So it's not too surprising that, you know, these spinning black holes might be a real thing, because as things fall into like drains, they generally spin around. So it's not too surprising to think of a spinning black hole, because most of the material falling into black holes are already spinning. But these Kerr black holes go above and beyond. Have you ever spun water in a glass before? So much so that, you know, a little bit in the middle parts and there's no water. Well, this could be happening in black holes, where the space-time around the black hole is getting dragged. This is called frame dragging. And at the center of the black hole, instead of just having, you know, a single singularity, a point, you actually have a ring. And if the black hole is massive enough, it needs to be huge. So the tidal force is gradual as you get closer to the singularity. So it doesn't, this spaghettification process doesn't happen. And you could possibly cross the middle of this ringed singularity, and who knows what will happen. Maybe it's a wormhole. You know, you come out the other side, or in another place in space or time, or another universe altogether. Well, no one actually knows. And it could be much more boring than that. In the center of a black hole, it could just be a little bit of mass, and it's extremely dense. And, you know, if you fall into one, you're going to get crushed. Now, if this is where the show is going, and they're going to suggest that, you know, that these time machine devices use Kerr black holes, well, it doesn't really work, because you'd need huge black holes, like supermassive size, you know, the middle of galaxy size, where they're millions of times the mass of our sun. So I don't know how they're going to deal with that.
第137時は使い方にブラックホールができるかブラックホールタイムトラベルを実にブラックホールを使ったものがあったよな
So let's pause here, because there's a bunch we can talk about. So I noticed the report was 137, the fine structure constant, which is essentially strength of electromagnetism, has this funny value, 1 over 137. It's very mysterious, and that's obviously a ode to that. But anyway, these mini black holes at the LHC. Well, if you remember back, if you're old enough, there was a bunch of worry that, you know, the LHC might accidentally start producing black holes. And a lot of people correctly pointed out that you would need way more energy than the LHC is capable of producing to actually create black holes. However, there are some theories in theoretical physics which could actually make it possible for the LHC to produce micro or mini black holes. It's very much related to other dimensions and something called the hierarchy problem, which is has to do with the strength of gravity and why it is so much weaker than all of the other forces of nature, because it is very weak. In this hypothesis, it explains the weakness of gravity by suggesting that the universe is actually just a part of a larger, higher dimensional bulk, that the universe isn't all there is. There's much more out there, there's more dimensions, and that the gravity is actually really strong. However, gravity is the only force that actually can roam freely through the larger dimensional bulk. And because of that, it actually gets diluted. So in our little pocket of, you know, the broader thing, gravity is actually diluted, and it's actually much weaker compared to the other forces. And in this hypothesis, because gravity is actually so strong, it might be possible to merge gravity with the other forces at much lower energies. So something I should also say is that at the LHC, at high energies, some of the fundamental forces merge into each other. And that's the case for all the other fundamental forces except for gravity. We don't know how gravity interconnects to them, or we think that it might merge into one unified, all four of the forces into one unified force at extremely high energy. But our current theory suggests that you need a particle accelerator the size of the galaxy, or even larger, to unify these forces using a particle collision. So, but with this hypothesis, it might be possible with something the size of the LHC. It normally would require an insane amount of pressure and density to squeeze enough material together to make it collapse down to an infinite point of density. And if that's the case, you know, the LHC is not even close to operating at high enough energies to produce black holes. However, with this other theory and hypothesis in theoretical physics, it very well might be. But if the force of gravity is actually a lot stronger than we think, then gravity could easily overwhelm the other forces and we could easily create black holes at the LHC. And it could be happening, but we currently see no signs of it. If the LHC really is creating microscopic black holes, you don't need to worry, because these things would disintegrate rapidly within like 10 to the negative 27 seconds, which is less than a trillion trillionth of a second. And these things should decay into standard model or supersymmetric particles, and we should be seeing a bunch of tracks. We currently don't see them, so this is why this whole sort of theory is kind of out the door. But so if we saw microscopic black holes at the LHC, that would suggest extra dimensions, and it would be super cool. Also important to note here, you wouldn't be able to use microscopic black holes for any sort of time travel like this anime is suggesting, because like I've already mentioned, you'd need a Kerr black hole, which would need to be enormous so the tidal forces don't spaghettify you. I really enjoyed watching, and I'll probably do more in the future. And if you have any good ideas for things within this show that I can react to, leave a comment down under so I can sift through them and find cool bits and pieces about the show that I can possibly elaborate on.